Jason Duell on the website Theosophical Ruminations asks an atheist if he has any evidence for God's non-existence. Recently, the YouTube user InternetPastorTV commented on one of my videos, demanding that I prove that God does not exist. And if you've been on the internet for any extended period, you've probably seen this demotivator, which states about atheists, there is no way to prove a God doesn't exist, but they believe it strongly. And this brings us to the fourth lie that Christians tell, and why they tell it. That you can't prove that God does not exist. This is one of their worst lies because it comes in two parts. One is explicitly stated, and the other part is implied. One part is true, and the other part is false. And half lies are the worst lies of all. Let's start with the first half. You can't prove that God does not exist. This is the explicit part, and the true part. It's a fact. You can't prove that God doesn't exist. I can't either. Nobody can. In theory, you can prove that God does not exist as described, since his existence is sorely out of sync with logic and with reality. In theory, you can prove that the Bible that describes this God is an unreliable text, since it contradicts itself, like the way it describes two separate deaths of Judas Iscariot. In Matthew, he throws down the silver he gets for betraying Jesus. In Acts, he keeps it. In Matthew, the chief priests use the silver that Judas threw down to buy a field. In Acts, Judas uses the silver to buy a field. In Matthew, he dies hanging himself. In Acts, he dies falling on a rock. But Christians have a remarkable ability to believe self-contradictory things. And since gods are usually magical and given to working in mysterious ways, it doesn't matter if anything they supposedly do actually makes sense. So no, you can't prove that God does not exist. That's the first part. The entire lie, however, neatly summed up, is that you cannot prove that God does not exist, which indicates that God does, or reasonably, might exist. This is a lie because the inability to prove non-existence is not particular to the Christian God, or any God. And not just the popular ones like Allah or Vishnu. It also applies to other gods like Zeus and Thor. It applies to other mythical characters like Atlas, who is technically a titan, and Andromeda, a mortal in a mythological tale. You can't prove that they don't exist. In fact, you can't prove that any conceivable thing does not exist. This was demonstrated by Bertrand Russell in 1952. He pointed out that if he claimed that there was a teapot in space orbiting the sun, nobody would be able to prove that there wasn't a teapot. And indeed, nobody has been able to prove that the teapot does not exist. And yet, there are no people who profess belief in the teapot, nor is there a lobby arguing that we should teach the controversy between the teapot and evidenced reality. Nor are there people who suspend belief in the teapot. Sane, rational people accept that there is no evidence for the teapot, and so they don't believe in it. This is because sane, rational people know that the inability to prove that something does not exist neither indicates nor suggests that this thing does exist. This understanding has led to the inventions of the invisible pink unicorn and the flying spaghetti monster as a means of poking fun at religious types. These two things were made up, one in 1990 and one in 2005, and still, much to their chagrin, Christians are unable to prove that either one does not exist. In fact, since 2005, a supposed believer in the flying spaghetti monster has offered $1 million American dollars to anyone who can provide any empirical evidence that Jesus is not the son of the flying spaghetti monster. The money remains unclaimed. So the truth is that you cannot prove that any conceivable thing does not exist. But this indicates absolutely nothing. Certainly not that the thing in question does exist. Christians are aware of this. A few lines down from issuing this challenge to an atheist, Jason Duell admits to knowing that certain kinds of negatives just can't be proven. Which begs the question, if you know that it can't be done, why issue the challenge? Simple. Christians tell this lie because there's no evidence that any God exists, which makes the similarity between gods and imaginary friends a bit too striking for comfort. To get around this, they draw attention to the fact that you can't prove that God doesn't exist, even though they know that this applies to everything and indicates nothing. They do it so that they can pretend that it is reasonable to believe that God does exist. Even if you point out that there's no evidence that God exists, they can then pretend that it's some kind of stalemate, and that it's reasonable to go either way. But of course that's not true either, and they know it, which is why they don't apply this lie to anything else, like Smurfs or fairies, even though the lie works just as well for them as it does for any god. They know that the only reason to believe that something exists is because there is evidence for that thing. And of course there isn't any for any god, which makes their belief in God impossible to justify. If you know of a lie that Christians like to tell, please send me a message with that lie and I'll make a video about it. Other than that, please rate the video, subscribe, and wait for more. There's more coming.